really sweet relaxation pose called hammock. And it's kind of fun to access from here, so that's why we're leaning back. And anytime that we're doing something today and you feel like you need a break, this is your go-to. This is your cocoon. And it's 100% okay to take breaks. You know, let yourself rest. Enjoy the relaxation time. So from our cocoon, we're simply going to stretch our arms over our head towards the back wall. Maybe wiggle and play like you're in your metamorphosis and you're growing past the edges of your womb and you're ready to exit into the room, into the space. So your fingers and your toes are just exploring. Maybe a gentle rocking from side to side. Stretch, 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 stretch everything. That feels good. And then we're all going to use the left leg loop. We can remove the right one. So the right leg and the left leg are going to enter the left leg loop. So cross the ankles, both legs in the left, just release the right. That's nice. And then your arms are going to come up overhead. You're going to pull from the back edge of the swing. Come to sit and then awesome out the back. So gather the swing underneath your arms. Get your head out. Mm-hmm. Your head and your shoulders come out. Good. Beautiful. It's like a female leg. So this extra leg loop, this right leg loop, we're going to put this on behind our head. And then we're going to put it on like a t-shirt underneath our arms. So see if you can thread that through. So underneath your neck and then underneath the arms. There you go. And now we're double supported, right? Behind our back. Get comfortable. The chillaxers. Yeah. Lean back a little bit more and it'll be comfortable. Lean back even more. Even more. Yes. There you go. You got to sprout. Beautiful. Make sure you're not kicking your buddy. Just make sure you have enough room for your legs. Everybody looks good. And then chillaxing arms is usually my go-to. So interlace your fingers behind the back of your head. Yes. And then let your elbows flare out wide. Now lean back into it. It's a supported back bend. So even though this is a relaxation pose, it's really great for the upper back. Lean back even more, Joanne. It might feel a little bit better to slide it down. Yes, like that. There you go. It's like going back down birth canal. Okay, so Sarah, will you do me a favor and just switch so you're with us? So we're in the left leg loop. Oh, yeah, just so we don't have a bop. A bump when we go the other way. Thank you, honey. Okay. So from here, I'm going to reach up. I'm going to grab from the top of the leg loop. And I'm going to get it out from underneath my armpits. And it's still around my neck. I'm going to position it so it's spread out. And then, like I'm putting on like a little bonnet, I'm going to let my arms drop to the sides and get a gentle neck stretch. Now, it's up to you how much pressure is in the neck. You can support your head with your hands, or you can drop your hips, or you can push your hips up and make it a little bit more intense. But just enjoy a gentle neck stretch. Now, the swing, the leg loop is spread out, so it's like bigger than the length of the ears. So it's not bunched up underneath the cervical spine. Perfect, guys, that looks good. Maybe add a little twist, gently rock your hips from side to side. Good. Beautiful. Let's do second side. Reach up, grab for the leg loop. You can take it off. Come back into your swing. Okay. Another rest. That right leg loop is going to come around. You can just give it like a little flip. Both legs are going into the right leg loop. Cross the ankles if you can. Take the left one off. Take a pause here. If you're happy with just both legs in the right one, there you go, thank you, Sue. Then just stay here. You don't have to do the upper body and the hammock pose. But this is very cool in its own right, just to hang. If you want to blossom, reach up and grab for the back of the swing. Get your head out. Get your arms out. So you're bunching it up underneath the armpits. And then you reach for the left leg loop. And then you put it behind the head. You get both arms through. And then you bunch it up. You bunch it up behind the back. Yes, it's like putting on a t-shirt. And then slightly to get a deeper stretch, but it kind of tractions and massages out that stickiness that lives along the rhomboids and shoulder blades that gets tightened. So this tends to be a really fun, popular pose. Well, we go as far as it feels good for today. You get to choose how much lift you have in the hips, how much you lean back into it. Looks great. And then we're slowly going to transition. So we reach up, we grab for the top of the leg loop. We sink our hips down so we can, it's a little bit spring loaded, so be gentle so we can get that back around the neck. And we're going to let it cover the full length of the ears. It's really important that we don't clench it up behind the cervical spine, that we actually put it on like a little head bonnet. And then from there, we can let our arms dangle towards the floor. Real gentle neck stretch. I like rocking my hips from side to side. See if that feels good. Arms can always support the head and neck if you need. Just pick your favorite position. Beautiful, guys. Okay, so we're going to reach up, grab for the leg loop, come back to sit, come into your cocoon. So both leg loops have to go back on, one on each foot. Nice. Okay, is anybody up for doing an inversion today?
Yes?
Yes. Okay. If you're not, cocoon is going to be your go-to. Okay? I'm going to show you what's going to happen next, and then you can tell me if you want to do it or if you just want to hang out here, but I want to give people lots of different options. Okay? So I'm going to reach, can you guys see me from your little cocoons?
Yeah.
I'm going to let my arms come back and overhead. I'm going to reach for the front of my swing, and I'm going to hold onto it and bring my legs wide. And maybe this is as far as I can for today. Okay? And then if that's comfortable, I'm going to bend my knees and wrap my legs around. And then I'm upside down. Okay, so I'll show you one more time. We'll do it together. I'll spot you if you want. So you're going to birth out the back, right? So get your head out, get your arms out. Reach for the front of the swing. Mm-hmm. So this is key. You have to pull and bring the legs wide. That's it, Sue. That's it. Yeah, so go ahead and lean back as you pull and gather it kind of underneath your bum a little bit more. That's it. And then when you lean back, keep your legs wide, lean back, and then you're going to wrap your legs around the swing. Your legs go wide and around. And then you're upside down. How good. I will spot you. Yeah. So one more time. Lean back, hold on to this side. Legs wide and around. Wide. And then lean back. Hold on to the swing. Revert. Keep pulling it. Legs wide and around. Now you don't need the swing over your butt, but since we were already sitting in it, it was fine. Okay? Stay in cocoon. Go ahead and relax your arms down to the ground if you're upside down. Or come back to cocoon. Yes. Good. Beautiful, guys. Yeah. Come on back into your cocoon if you're done. Whenever you're ready. So you bring your legs wide and around, you come to sit, hop back in. Good job, guys. So it's probably not the way you normally access an inversion, but the good news about that pose is when you come out, you're sitting in your cocoon again, right? So that's like, oh, well, that's nice. So there's a benefit of that. I'm going to show you one more time so you can kind of get a sense of how to do it at home if you practice at home. You bring your arms out. You have to reach for the front, bring your legs wide. See, my swing gathers at my butt. If it doesn't gather, it makes it difficult, and then the legs can. Now once I'm here, I can choose to bring the swing all the way to my back, or I can stretch it across my butt. And that way when I come to sit, I come and sit in the swing. Okay, a little bit of a trick there. So let's all wind up here. Let's extend the legs. We're going to do some bicep curls.
reach for the front edge of the swing. Reach up as high as you can. Front edge of the swing. Good. Reach up higher. Straight arms reach up. Good. Legs wide. Cool. So the movement is bicep curl wide legs. Bicep curl wide legs. Yes. Bicep curl wide legs. If you can eventually come to sit, the swing will gather at your back. So bring your legs wide and just kind of pull it up. Yes, you're getting there.
As we lift our heart up, just
thicker. If you're happy, you want to go deeper, hug the lips towards you. It's kind of like a floating child's pose. Big stretch. And then exhale, boxing for star, and then underneath the spine a few times with breath like that. Exhale, hug and squeeze the lips towards your child's. Inhale, boxing star. Beautiful. Exhale, child. Stay here, jazz hands, shake it out, shake it out. Put back to chillax in arms. I'm going to keep leaning back with my heart and head, but my hips are going to stay heavy, right? That's the stretch. Extend that right leg up towards the sky for extended leg twist. Let it slide up the leg loop. Yeah, get back on there soon. So come on back to pigeon and slide up. There you go. Yeah, it stays hooked. So Durant's on the other side of the leg loop. Bring your foot on the other side. Yes, and then it can slide up. There you go. Slide it up. Leg slides. So if you want to try the twist, we're going to look down underneath the right armpit. Jazz hands. Stay here if that's enough of a stretch, or grab for your foot. So if the foot seems unreasonable, don't worry about it. Otherwise, extend the arms into a G. Extended leg twist. Yes, you gotta get used to all that pressure behind your back. Release, unfurl, come through, swagger, second side. There you go. So if the swing needs to come lower, all you're gonna do is reach up and hold on, lean back, get it to slide down, and then come sit again. So try to keep the wings hooked by using chillaxin arms for the forearm press. All right, in time that gets easy. So get the left foot on top. Yes. Pressing the knee down, hips down. Gently rock from side to side. I call it wagging the tail so that right foot is just exploring in the space. If you don't like all the sway, you can just stay still for more of a chill. And then if you want to go deeper, stay here if you're happy. Or we're going to inhale, open the arms, and exhale, hug the leg towards your child's pose. And then inhale, blossom for star. Exhale, hug it in to child's. Beautiful. Inhale, blossom. Exhale, squeeze. Last time, inhale, blossom. Stay here. Use your chillaxin arms to support the head. And now that left leg can just straighten up the side. So first just look down through left armpit. Maybe that's enough of a twist. If you want to do the arms extended, leg extended, you can grab from the foot or not. See what's available to you. Extend the leg twist. It's actually the other twist, the other left armpit. No, yeah. There you go. This way. Slowly unfurl, come on out. We're going to come through again some Shiva sequence. Open up the hips. We have about 15 more minutes and then a nice long shavasana, so just stick with it. You're doing great. So we're going to reach for our knees. Okay. Slide up the leg loops as high as possible. These are our stabilizers, right? So we're going to hold on to them and stay stable. We're going to first inhale and open up. Lots of biceps today. I don't know why. That's just what we're doing. Exhale, squeeze. Dial in like a child's pose. Inhale, open. Bicep curl, lift the chest. Perfect. Exhale, squeeze. Slowly opening up the front of the hips. Inhale, lift. One more time. Exhale, squeeze. Loosening up all that tightness. This time we're going to lift and extend the legs. See if we can balance straight up and down. Maybe you lift the hips. Maybe you drop the hips. Lift the hips. Drop the hips. See what that feels like. Splits. Lean forward with the heart, not the head, the heart. Yes, lean forward with the hips. Skydiver, see the skydiver is a little bit harder, isn't it? Now bend the elbows, bend the knees. We're going to bring the feet together, flying butterfly. Ooh la la. See if you can get the feet together. Mm-hmm. Yep.
There the elbows.
Slide in. Give it a bit. Slide in.
It's probably the one that
wants to take a stretch. There you go.
That's my shorter way.
Yeah, mine can slide up too, so
I'm wondering. Maybe you guys
have,
that's hilarious. You too.
We found the match.
Yes.
All right, this is how we get out of here. We pull the feet down towards the ground, sink your hips back, and then use your arms to catch them off. Let's come on back up to our high dive we're trying again. Now you notice why we started out with this one, right? It's a little bit easier with the leg loops up higher. Plus, it's nice to get the underarms a break, so we'll try it one more time. Remember,
yeah.
Switch those leg lifts out. Okay, so we lean back, right? Bring your hands onto the swing. Bring your hands to prayer. Sit behind the leg loops. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, front of the swing behind the leg loops. Press forward, press, and then away. It's always good to revisit. All right, so we're teeing the arms. We're going to bank a little from side to side. Bring the prayer forward. Getting to entitlement theory. And if you let the legs slide, I like to kind of negotiate with the leg loops, get them on the outside of the bones, and then you can bend them side to side. Let's try this one again. Beautiful, guys. Really nice. So I like to lead with the heart, right? So head up, heart leading the way. There it is. Perfect. All right, let's try the elbows again. So slide in. Okay? Once you slide in, so this is our butterfly. It's like we just did before, but you notice it's more hips and not as much upper body as it was in the last one. Beautiful, guys. Okay, land it. Let's do a few more hip stretches today. So I like to get right underneath my plumb line. Yes, lift the heart, lean back. Now I'm going to keep the leg loops towards the outside of my bum. Swing is going to go around the neck, so plant your feet. This is a little bit more of the restorative that I like to do. Hold on to the swing. Let the swing kind of gather around your neck, lean back. Make sure your feet are on the ground. Yes. We're like, are you sure? Yeah, check in on that one before you just go for it. So yes, I got the neck. And then you're just going to tuck your chin into your chest. Let that feel good. And then you're going to lift your chin. So I stay holding on to the swing the whole time, so it keeps my neck nice and safe. So lift the chin, tuck the chin. Good. Now if anybody feels comfortable, you can try and float, right? So you can let your feet lift, the knees bend, the hips drop slightly, and then you have a little bit more of a deeper stretch. Chin stays tucked into this part. Yes. So slow your roll, Sarah. Sway. Stay underneath your plumb line. Beautiful. And then if you want to bend your elbows, you can hold them closer to your ears and then really get a good stretch. Lift the chin, tuck the chin. Oh yeah. Lift the chin. The chin. Great. Everybody land it. Your chuckle grabbing swing with your feet together. So if anybody has chronic neck and shoulder tension, that's a really great stretch. Okay, we're going to open up the legs a little bit more now and come through our lunges. So, swing goes back behind the heart. Hold on to the leg loops, lift the knees, do a little tractioning on your way down. Get your foam rolling in. Right, get a little massage action, only if it feels good. Try lifting one knee and then the other knee, one leg at a time, see how that feels. It's very camp dependent. If you have a slippery fabric, it works a little bit better. Yeah, you can really work it. Just take a few moments to feel that tissue evolving session that happens with the leg loops. Eventually feels good. Cool. Once we're here, we're going to do that same movement where we hold on to the leg loops. We're going to keep the right knee bent so you can shift and come on top of the mat. Now the hips, yes. So that's what's going to happen. So Kimberly is going to guide us through the alternative of bringing the left foot down. Now, you got to get it into like a comfortable spot here. Once it's down, you can push the right arm straight. Really straighten that back leg, Sarah. Make good alignment there. There you go. Left. Right knee bent, left leg straight. Yeah. So, will you push this one forward?
This one?
Forward. There you go. That's good. There you go. So you can kind of help the hip to open. Right? Back leg really straight. Plant. Good. It's like a bow and arrow. Right? Let's change sides. Gonna drop both hips. Another rocking session, and then shift onto the left. Maybe the right foot comes down. You can float if you want. Let's all try it. I know, pinchy, pinchy. And then we're going to start with the left leg. Now, in time, we can float, but until the hips open, we have lots of different alternatives. You are spring loaded. That's right. An arrow like flying. Head directly over the body by lifting the heart. Beautiful, that's it. Really nice. Wow. Nice, everyone. Okay, come on back. Let's try that one more time. So that's your alternative. Bring the foot down if the hips don't want to open. But let's try right knee bent, roll to the top of the left. Okay? If it's possible, yes, keep rolling the hip down towards the ground. Beautiful. Straighten the back arm if you're there. Otherwise, the first alternative is a fantastic choice. Now, if you're here and you want to grab for the foot, let's just go for it. Bend the knee, grab for the foot. This is our full Shiva. See if you can do thumb up. If you grab up, yes. That changes the shoulder position. Beautiful. Okay, release. It's roundabout. Come into second side. Really nice, Joanne. Stick with the first alternative. So we're going to keep left knee bent. Roll into the top of the right. Where that foot might just naturally come down. Open up the chest. Bend the back leg, grab the foot. That's where you might go today. Wherever you are, just feel that stretch, feel the openness. Relax into it. Where is there more space that can be had? Beautiful. Nice. Okay, release. Come on back down. Let's sway it out. Swagger. All right. So we have one more chill flow, and then we're going to be wrapping it up. Really nice, guys. So drop the hips, open the heart, head relaxes back. I'm going to show you how to come into a bow pose from here. And if bow feels like too much, just kind of hang out here in our chillaxing pose. But the first part we all can do, we're just going to undulate the spine one more time. Inhale, take the arms. Exhale, stars in the arms and the legs. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Inhale, go ahead and round in and squeeze. Exhale, child. Inhale, blossom for star. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Exhale, squeeze and round in for child. Good. Doesn't that feel good? Inhale, blossom. Exhale, round in and squeeze. So child's pose is another good rest place. Inhale, blossom. If you want to continue on, we're going to squeeze the legs together, hands to prayer. Namaste. A little bit different when it's at the knees. Press up and lean back. So hips lift, head relaxes back. Hold it down with the forearms. And then we're going to reach up and grab for the swing and slide into the waist. So one more ladle pose. So this might be as far as you go for the inversion. So head points down towards the ground, swing slides towards the waist. Maybe you need to wiggle in a little bit, wherever you are, just be happy. If you want to go into the full bow pose, bend your knees. Your hands can reach back for your ankles, or overhead, or stay holding onto the swing. Just wherever it feels right for today. If you hold onto your ankles, I want you to pull your knees towards one another so that they are in alignment with your hips. Beautiful. Press the chest forward. Nice big opener. Nice, guys. Release the ankles nice and slow. Reach up. safe in ins and outs. Yes, I know. We've been in the swing for about 12 hours. This whole part of the body is like, ah, singing opera. Oh, my God. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I am.